Give me red. Red!
High five.
You have to collect data because you need to know where the kids are and where the gaps are, and that will inform what you teach to. So, I mean, not only do I have to collect data on their IEP goals, I also have to collect data on things that aren't on their IEP goals. You know, just because it's not a goal doesn't mean I'm not collecting data on it. But collecting data also gives me information on how they learn. You know, if I know that I'm constantly having to give a certain kind of prompt to a child, if they're constantly needing visual prompts, that means that this child really doesn't respond to verbal directives. When you collect data, you learn more than just about what you're collecting the data on. Collecting data on something like pre-academic skills gives me information on behavior, gives me information on reinforcers, and all of that stuff I then get to file away and use again the next time I work with them. And you have to see where they are so that you know where they're going and where you need to get them and how to help them get to the next place. Actually, another way of collecting data and a useful way to kind of get parents into their child's day. It's a form that I made up using Board Maker, Today in School I, and I circle all the things that they did during the day so that parents know what questions to ask their child. I also have related services. Hi.
Hey.
This is yours. Did you have speech today? No.
No.
And that way they can know if their child got their related services, and it helps them kind of keep track of that schedule. Then at the bottom there's a place for comments, and I can write if there was something their child particularly enjoyed. Like Silas enjoyed reading Chicka Chicka Boom Boom today and touching the letters. So that's something that I would put on here. I also can put if they need something, like we need an extra change of clothes, we need more of a particular kind of food that we know they love. So anything can go on this home letter. And parents also use this to communicate with me too, that we write each other back and forth. So even though I don't talk to them every day on the phone, I communicate with them every single day. And especially with kids in this population who aren't or might not be particularly verbal, I think it's not only reassuring for parents to have this, but it's also just a really good way to help them connect with their kids and like bridge that school-home gap. So, and it's super easy. Made it in 5 minutes. These are folders that our school has provided for us, but you can make them yourself, and I have made them. One pocket, return to school. One pocket, keep at home. With children in the PPCD setting, there's always a lot of forms that need to be sent home, signed, and returned. So this is just an easy way to keep yourself organized and to help parents out, because a lot of times it can get really chaotic. The folder can become chaotic, and there's so much stuff going on that it helps them stay organized with what they can keep and what they can send, what they need to send back to school.